लिटिल चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू नेहाज अलार्म क्लॉक। नेहाज अलार्म क्लॉक, क्लास फोर्थ, इंग्लिश बुक मैरीगोल्ड, यूनिट वन, पार्ट टू। नेहाज अलार्म क्लॉक। इन दिस स्टोरी देयर इज अ गर्ल नेहा। In the morning, she wants to sleep more. Her alarm clock, bird, sun, and her mother awake her in the morning. She wants to sleep more. First, she says something for clock and the alarm clock stops to ring. Next day, the birds don't turn up to chirp. Third day, the sun doesn't come to wake her up. And the last day, mother doesn't tell her anything to wake up. But fifth day, she sees that there is a system in her body which tells her to wake up early in the morning and go to school. Now today, we will study the question and answers of this chapter. First question: who was the first to pull Neha out of bed? Answer: Neha's alarm clock was the first to pull Neha out of bed. It always rang at 6 o'clock in the morning to awake her. Neha's alarm clock was the first to pull Neha out of bed. It always rang at 6 o'clock in the morning to awake her. Now, my littles, some word meanings have been written on the page. Please learn those meanings. Neha's alarm clock was the first to pull Neha out of bed. It always rang at 6 o'clock in the morning to awake her. Now question number 2. What time did Neha's alarm always ring? Answer: Neha's alarm always rang. Ring. There are 3 forms of the verb. Ring. Here we will use rang because we are talking about past. Neha's alarm always rang at 6 o'clock in the morning. In spite of 6 o'clock in the morning, you can write 6 a.m. A.m. must be written in small letters. Neha's alarm clock always rang at 6 o'clock in the morning. In spite of 6 o'clock in the morning, you can write 6 a.m. Now let us go for question number 3. Third, what did she do when her alarm rang? Answer: when her alarm rang, she made a face. Number 1, she made a face. Number 2, she covered her ears with a pillow. Number 2, she covered her ears with a pillow. And number 3, she snuggled under the warm blanket because she wanted to sleep more. Now please learn the word meanings and 3 forms of the verb given on this page. Okay, when her alarm rang, she made a face, she covered her ears with a pillow and snuggled under the warm blanket. Now question number 4. Why did she cover her ears with a pillow? Why did she cover her ears with a pillow? She covered her ears with a pillow so that the sound of alarm clock might not disturb her. Why? Because she wanted to sleep more. You can change the answer. If you want to write any other answer, you can write. You can write in this manner also. She covered her ears with a pillow so that she might not be disturbed. She might not be disturbed by the sound of the alarm clock because she wanted to sleep more. Question number 5. In spite of coming out of the bed, what did Neha want? Answer. Neha wanted to sleep a little longer. In spite of coming out of the bed, Neha wanted to sleep a little longer. She wanted to sleep more. Because her mother tells she is a sleepy head. Then, in spite of coming out of the bed, what did Neha want? Answer. Neha wanted to sleep a little longer, or Neha wanted to sleep more. Yes, in spite of coming out of the bed, Neha wanted to sleep more. Question number 6. What did she want the clock to forget? Please answer. Okay. She wanted the clock to forget its job. And what was the job of the clock? It was to ring. Ting tong. So, she wanted the clock to forget its job. To ring. Why? Because the clock disturbs her in her sleep. She wants to sleep more. Therefore, she wanted the clock to forget its job to ring. Now the next question. Question number 7. What happened to Neha's clock next day? What happened to Neha's clock next day? Answer. Next day, Neha's clock fell down. Neha's clock fell down and it was broken. It stopped ringing. Next day, Neha's clock fell down and it was broken. It stopped ringing. Please learn all the forms of verb. Stopped. Yes. Break, broke, broken. Yes. Happen, happened. Now, question number 8. Why was Neha happy? Answer. Neha was happy because her clock had fallen. She thought that she could get up late from next day as the clock would not ring. Neha was happy because her clock had fallen. She thought that she could get up late from next day as the clock would not ring. Why was Neha happy? Neha was happy because her clock had fallen. She thought that she could get up late from next day as the clock would not ring. Now, question number 9. who was the second to pull Neha out of bed. First was alarm clock, but that too stopped working. Then who was the second to pull Neha out of bed? Answer, the small chirpy birds were the second to pull Neha out of bed. The small chirpy birds were the second to pull Neha out of bed. First was alarm clock. Second, chirpy birds. Third, sun. Fourth, mother. And last one, fifth one, Neha herself. Neha herself. The answer of this question is the small chirpy birds were the second to pull Neha out of bed. Now, question number 10. How did the small chirpy birds pull Neha out of bed? How did the small chirpy birds pull Neha out of bed? Answer is, the small chirpy birds started chirping to pull Neha out of bed. The small chirpy birds started chirping to pull Neha out of bed. The birds started chirping. Yes. One bird sat on windowsill and others entered in Neha's room. They told her to wake fast. They told her to wake up fast. The small chirpy birds started chirping to pull Neha out of bed. One bird sat on windowsill and others entered in Neha's room. They told her to wake up fast. They told her to wake up fast. Now question number 11. What did Neha thank for the chirpy birds? What did Neha thank for the chirpy birds? Answer. Neha thought. Think, thought, thought. Think, thought, thought. Neha thought, why the chirpy birds don't leave her alone? Neha wondered, why the chirpy birds don't leave her alone? Neha thought, why the chirpy birds don't leave her alone? What did Neha think for the chirpy birds? Neha thought, why the chirpy birds don't leave her alone? Neha thought, why the chirpy birds don't leave her alone? Now question number 12. What happened next day? What happened next day? When Neha thought, why the chirpy birds don't leave her alone, then what happened next day? Answer. Next day, the birds did not disturb Neha. The birds did not chirp. They didn't come to wake her up. Next day what happened? Next day the birds didn't disturb Neha. They didn't come in the room of Neha. And they didn't come to wake her up. They didn't chirp. They didn't chirp. So next day the birds did not disturb Neha. They did not come to wake her up. They did not come to wake her up. Now the next question, 13. Who else did not want her to miss the school bus? Who else did not want her to miss the school bus? Answer. The big bright sun also didn't want her to miss the school bus. The big bright sun also did not want her to miss the school bus. To miss the school bus. Who else did not want her to miss the school bus? Please give the answer. The big bright sun also did not want her to miss the school bus. First was alarm clock. Second was chirpy birds. And the third is big bright sun. Now my children, you have to tell me, What did the son do in Neha's room? What did the son do in Neha's room? How did the son awake Neha? How did the son awake Neha? Answer is, the son filled Neha's room with a warm smile and bright sun rays. She was compelled to wake up. Now, the sun filled her room with a warm smile. Warm smile means bright sun rays. Earlier there was darkness, but sun brings their smile. Question number 15. What did Neha think for the sun? First of all, she thought for the alarm clock. Then she thought for the chirpy birds. Now she thought for the sun. So what did Neha think for the sun? Neha thought, why the sun don't let her be? Neha thought, why the sun don't leave her alone? She thought the same thing for alarm clock, same thing for birds. Now she is thinking the same thing for the sun. She is telling, Neha thought, why the sun don't leave her alone? Neha thought, why the sun don't let her be? Now let us go for the next question, 16. Where did the sun hide the next morning? Next morning, the sun didn't turn up. Didn't rise in the sky. There was darkness. So then, where did the sun hide the next morning? Answer, the sun hid. Hide, hid, hidden. You have to learn all the three forms of a verb. Where did the sun hide the next morning? The sun hid behind the clouds the next morning. The sun hid behind the clouds the next morning. Where did the sun hide the next morning? The sun hid behind the clouds the next morning. Now the next question, 18. Who said, wake up, sleepyhead, you will miss the bus? Who said, wake up, sleepyhead, you will miss the bus? Answer, Neha's mother. It was Neha's mother who said, wake up, sleepyhead, you will miss the bus. Sleepyhead, one who wants to sleep more even after full sleep. Yes, you can write this answer in short form. Answer, Neha's mother told this to Neha. Neha's mother told this to Neha. Yes, let me repeat it now. Who said, wake up, sleepyhead, you will miss the bus? Answer, Neha's mother said, wake up, sleepyhead. You will miss your school bus. Now the next question, number 18. What did Neha think for her mother? First, she thought for the alarm clock. It is stopped ringing. Next, she thought for the birds. They also stopped chirping. Now the third one was sun. Then sun hid behind the clouds. Now she is telling for her mother. What did Neha think for her mother? Neha thought, Why her mother has to wake her up? It is better if she doesn't wake her up. It is better if her mother does not wake her up. Now the next question, 19. What happened next day? What happened next day? Happen, happened, happened. You have to learn all the three forms of verb. Happen, happened, happened. H-A-P-P-E-N. H-A-P-P-E-N mein you will add E-D. Happened, happened. Then, what happened next day? Answer is, next day, there was none to wake her up. There was none to wake her up. She woke up herself. She woke up herself. Next day, there was none to wake her up. Neither alarm clock, nor chirpy birds, nor sun, yes, nor mother. So next day, there was none to wake her up. She woke up herself. Now the next question, 20. What did Neha ask her mother? What did Neha ask her mother? The three forms of ask. Ask, asked, A-S-K, A-S-K-E-D, and A-S-K-E-D. Neha asked her mother, who woke her up? Neha asked her mother, who woke her up? What did Neha ask her mother? What did Neha ask her mother? She was surprised. She was very much surprised. Why? Because there was no alarm clock, no chirpy birds, no sun, no mother. Then she was surprised. Neha asked her mother, who woke her up? Who woke her up? Neha asked her mother, who woke her up? Now the next question, number 21. Why did Neha take her lunch every day at 1 in the afternoon? 1 in the afternoon. Why did Neha take her lunch every day at 1 in the afternoon? Answer. Neha took her lunch every day at 1 in the afternoon because she felt hungry at that time. She felt hungry at that time. In spite of 1 in the afternoon, you can write 1 p.m. P.m. must be written in small letters. Okay? Then the question is, why did Neha take her lunch every day at 1 in the afternoon? Answer, Neha took her lunch every day at 1 in the afternoon because she felt hungry at that time. She felt hungry at that time. Because she felt hungry at that time. Now the next question, my son. Question number 22. What is inside us? Which tells us when to eat, when to sleep, and when to wake up? What is inside our body? What is inside us? Which tells us when to eat, when to sleep, and when to wake up? Answer number 22. There is a clock inside us. There is a clock. God made clock. Although there is no clock inside our body, but our system. There is a clock inside us which tells us when to eat, when to sleep, and when to wake up. Our body system is so well framed. Our body system is so well framed that we can do all the works without a watch. We can do all the works without a watch. But we have developed a habit to use the watch. In ancient time, our ancestors didn't have any watch. Now I'm making you understand this question. What is inside us? Which tells us when to eat, when to sleep, and when to wake up? Answer. There is a clock inside us. There is a man-made, but God-made clock. There is a God-made clock inside our body. Which tells us when to eat, when to sleep, and when to wake up. Our body system is so well framed. Our body system is so well framed that we can do all the works without a watch. But we have developed a habit to use the watch. In ancient times, our ancestors didn't have any watch. And they perform all the duties very well. Understand? So there is no watch in our body. It is a system. Now question number 23. By which vehicle did Neha go to school? By which vehicle did Neha go to school? Answer, Neha went to school by school bus. Neha went to school or Neha used to go to school by school bus. By which vehicle did Neha go to school? Neha went to school by school bus, not by cycle, not by bike, not by three-wheeler, not by metro, not by aeroplane, not by helicopter, not by ship, not on foot, but by school bus, but from, not from, but by school bus. Now, question number 24. Who wanted Neha to wake up? Who wanted Neha to wake up early in the morning and not to miss the school bus? Now you have to tell all the names. Yes, but who wanted Neha to wake up early in the morning and not to miss the school bus? Number one, clock, alarm clock. Number two, birds. Number three, sun. Number four, her mother. And the fifth one, who was the fifth one? She herself. Yes, then the clock, birds, sun and her mother were there who wanted Neha to wake up early in the morning and not to miss the school bus. Fifth one also there, she herself was there. She herself, Neha was also not interested to leave the bus. Yes. Clock, birds, sun, her mother and she herself. Now, my littles, you have listened to all the question and answers of this chapter, comprehensive. Yes. Now, I am asking you MCQs. Who was the first to pull Neha out of bed? Who was the second to pull Neha out of bed? Who was the third to pull Neha out of bed? And who was the fourth to pull Neha out of bed? You have to select the answer yourself. I am repeating the questions. Who was the first to pull Neha out of bed? Question number two. Who was the second to pull Neha out of bed? Question number three. Who was the third to pull Neha out of bed? And question number fourth. Who was the fourth to pull Neha out of bed? Question number five. Who was the fifth to pull Neha out of bed? Question number sixth. What time did Neha's alarm always ring? What time did Neha's alarm always ring? 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock. You have to search it out. You have to write it out. Now the next question. Neha covered her ears with blanket, bed sheet. Now you have to search it out yourself. Okay. Question number eight. Who is called Sleepyhead in the story? Who is called Sleepyhead in the story? You are a to majedar sleepy head. Nowadays you sleep till 10 a.m. Now the last page of this video, MCQ, question number 9. Who called Neha Sleepyhead in the story? Who called Neha Sleepyhead in the story? Father, mother, sister, brother. Who? You have to search it out. Question number 10. Which time did Neha take her lunch every day? Which time did Neha take her lunch every day? Question number 11. What is inside us which tells us when to eat, when to sleep and when to wake up? Question number 12. By which vehicle did Neha go to school? Dear children, you will get the answer of these MCQs in the next video. Please take care. Be happy and healthy. Learn well. Study well, learn well and obey well. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Little children, वेलकम टू नेहाज